Australia and throughout the world, there are millions of contaminated sites. These include old server stations, sheep dips, tanneries, landfill sites, any contaminated factories and so forth. They're everywhere around the world and they have left loads of contaminated soil and water that need to be cleaned up. So how do we do that? How do we clean this stuff up? One way is bioremediation, and this involves using fungi, bacteria, plants, or their enzymes to degrade or munch up all those toxic chemicals and turn them into something less toxic or even harmless. In this experiment, we're trying to find some bacteria that can do the job. Now, you don't need to go and sneak into sealed off areas on contaminated sites. You can get this anywhere. I got my soil from a service station down the road from where I live. It's on a little patch of lawn next to the petrol bowser, okay? But you can get soil from anywhere. It could be your compost heap, it could be your garden, it could be, like I said, petrol stations, or if you're on a farm near the chemical storage shed. The really cool thing about this experiment is that it's real science. I have no idea what bacteria might be present in this soil, but what bacteria are there, there's likely to be species that are unknown to science. Will they break down the engine oil that I got from home? I have no idea, but we're about to find out. This is a handy way of setting up your experiment and controls by writing the ingredients for each of the four beakers down on a bit of paper. Now, we've got our beakers set up, we've got to put some oil in. 2 mils approximately into each of these beakers. These three are controls. Beaker 4 is the one where you put in everything. And now the nutrients, food for the bacteria. And all four into beaker 4. Now for the soil with our bacteria. Soil into beaker 4, soil into beaker 3. So in beaker 4, we have our oil, our water, our nutrients, the food for the bacteria, and our soil. Hopefully there's lots of cool bacteria that can munch up that oil. Beaker 3 has just the oil, the water, and the soil, but no nutrients. Beaker 2 has just the oil, the water, and nutrients, no soil. Beaker 1, just the oil and the water. Okay, so we've got all our beakers, we've got our bacteria, hopefully in our soil, but now we've got to keep the bacteria alive. We've given them nutrients, which is food for bacteria, but they also need oxygen. This is what this is for. This is an aquarium pump. It will bubble oxygen into each of these beakers and hopefully keep the bacteria alive. So you've got to put a little bit of foil, stops your water evaporating over each of these beakers. You can use a Petri dish lid if you like. Now, put that in there, in each one of them. Turn her on. And away we go. Once that started running for every couple of weeks or every few days, as often as you like, over about two or three week period, come back and do the grease spot test and we'll show you how to do that next. Okay, this is the grease spot test. This is where we figure out if the bacteria in our soil are any good at munching up the engine oil that we put into our beakers here. We take a sample from each of these four beakers. So we take a couple of drops from just under the surface from each of these beakers and we put them onto a piece of brown paper. When those drops dry, they will leave a little grease spot and we can measure the diameter of that grease spot. Now every few days we do the same thing, we take another grease spot test and we measure the diameter of that spot. If that spot is shrinking, that is a pretty good indication that there is some bacteria in our soil that are able to degrade the engine oil. And that's a very cool thing.